Unknown gunmen have kidnapped some students and teachers of Government Science College, Kagara, Niger State. Hi, welcome to What's Happening. These are the top 10 stories now. At number 10, the chairman of the Independent National Electoral Commission, Mahmood Yakubu, has said that the commission has received over 9,777 requests for additional polling units across the country. Yakubu said this during a sensitization visit on the creation of additional polling units in the Arewa Consultative Forum in Kaduna on Tuesday. The INEC chairman noted that there was growing demand for the creation of additional polling units, saying as from October 2020, when the commission received 5,700 requests for additional polling units, the number of requests have increased to 4,077 in just 4 months. At number 9, the federal government spends over 50 billion naira monthly subsidizing electricity in order not to take electricity away from the reach of the common man. The Minister of Power, Salim Aman, said this while receiving members of the Hausa Guild of Actors and Film Producers, otherwise known as Kannywood, in his office. In a statement issued in Abuja on Tuesday by his aide, Aaron Atimas, Maman expressed concern over the failure by the distribution companies to stabilize their operations and meet their financial obligations to other units in the sector. He said it was in response to this unfortunate development that the federal government had been forced to partly subsidize the sector so as not to price the cost of electricity out of the reach of the common man. At number 8, the Senate on Tuesday made a move to ban carrying of illegal firearms in the country and demanded stiffer punishments for anyone who bears such arms. The Red Chamber said the move would checkmate all forms of criminal activities in the country. Senate President Ahmed Lawan made the call in his contribution to a debate sponsored by Senator Uba Sani. The bill was initially passed in the 8th National Assembly, but was not signed into law by President Muhammadu Buhari. Lawan said that the security situation in the country could be made much better if the proliferation of illegal firearms was adequately checked. He, however, referred the bill to the Committee on Judiciary, Human Rights and Legal Matters. At number 7, suspected bandits who kidnapped travelers on the highway in Niger State on Sunday have released a video. The abductors released a video showing the travelers begging the state government to facilitate their release on Tuesday. The criminals are reportedly demanding 500 million naira as ransom for the release of the victims. The armed men had ambushed the commuters who were returning from a wedding in Rijal local government area of the state on Sunday and taken them to an unknown location. The senior official of the National Union of Road Transport Workers in Tejina told news sources that the kidnappers also shot dead 3 vigilante members who attempted to follow the abduction. In the video, victims can be seen crying and pleading with the government to pay the ransom in order for them to be released. At number 6, Kano State government on Tuesday donated 18.5 million naira to its indigents who were victims of the bloody clash between Hausa and Yoruba traders in Sasha Market, Akinyele local government area of Oyo State. Garba Mohammed, Commissioner for Information in the state, led a delegation to Ibadan to disburse the money, adding that the governor, Abdullahi Ganduje, was concerned about the incident. He said Ganduje had directed the team to visit the 185 victims and also deliberate on how they can continue their normal businesses in Ibadan. At number 5, the Nigeria Customs Service has seized 1,930 bags of 50 kg smuggled rice evacuated from various warehouses in Lagos and Ogun states. This is following the directive of the Comptroller General of the Nigeria Customs Service to various formations of the NCS to raid warehouses and markets across the southwest of smuggled foreign rice and other contraband items in the country. The coordinator of the strike for Zone A, Amadu Bello Shuaibu, said the directive was aimed at boosting local production of rice in the country. Shuaibu said the unit generated 708 million naira from false duty levy in the last 2 weeks. According to him, 1,227 rolls of chiffon textiles materials, 18 pallets of perfumes, cosmetics and bags, 2,064 cartons of electric bulbs, as well as 1,810 cartons of alcoholic and non-alcoholic wines were seized and will be forfeited to the federal government. At number 4, on Wednesday, an inferno destroyed part of the highly populated customs IDP camp in Maiduguri, Borno State. According to some displaced persons at the camp, the incident, which started at about 6 a.m., destroyed over 600 shelters and led to the death of a child with 2 old women injured. Another IDP said the fire was put out by the combined efforts of the IDPs, security agents and officials of the Federal and State Fire Service. But surprisingly, a fire broke out in another part of the same camp about 4 hours later, destroying many of the makeshift tents. The spokesman of the National Emergency Management Agency in the Northeast, Abdul Kadir Ibrahim, said a team has been dispatched to assess the damage at the camp. At number three, as part of the legal process of confirmation, the House of Representatives has commenced the screening of the new service chiefs recently appointed by President Muhammadu Buhari. Buhari had written to the House requesting the screening of the new military leaders. This is the first time the House will be embarking on such exercise, as it had always been done by the Senate. At the meeting on Wednesday, the chairman of the ad hoc committee for the screening, Baba Jimmy Benson, said the exercise was in accordance with the provisions of Section 18, Subsection 1 of the Armed Forces Act, Cap A20 Law of the Federation of Nigeria 2004, which requires that the nominees be confirmed by the National Assembly. Benson said the committee will be thorough and grill the new service chiefs on areas of personal skills and experience, insurgency and general insecurity, personnel welfare, among others. At number two, the Senate has called on President Muhammadu Buhari to declare a state of emergency over the escalating insecurity across the country. The upper chamber made the call on Wednesday, further calling on Buhari's administration to implement the various recommendations of the Senate on how to tackle insecurity. President of the Senate Ahmed Lawan noted that the frequent incidents of kidnapping, especially of students, would reverse the gains made in school enrollment over the years in the North. In contribution, Senator Muhammad Bimar Enagi described the federal government as incompetent in dealing with the rising insecurity in the country. Finally, at number one, unknown gunmen have kidnapped some students and teachers of Government Science College, Kagara, Niger State. The armed men stormed the school in military uniforms around 2 a.m. on Wednesday, shooting sporadically. One student was said to have been killed in the process. According to reports, the attackers, who arrived on 33 motorcycles, overpowered the security guards on duty before whisking away students and teachers. The school is said to have a headcount of about 1,000 students, but so far the number of kidnapped students is still unknown. Reacting to the incident, the governor of Niger State, Abubakar Sani Bello, has ordered the immediate closure of all boarding schools in Rafi, Monya, Shiroro, and Mariga local government areas of the state. President Muhammadu Buhari has also directed security agencies to ensure the immediate and safe return of all the students abducted from the school. In a tweet, the personal assistant to the president on new media, Bashir Ahmed, said Buhari has dispatched a team of security chiefs to coordinate the rescue operation in Niger State. Always remember to wear your mask, wash your hands, and stay safe. That's all for today. See you next time on What's Happening.